What's up, YouTube? It's E-Tech here, and I'm going to give you a short, nice, quick little video on the Nexus 6P. So here you can see the release specs. These specs are released by Google. See, these are all official. You can read them here, but I'm also going to say them to you. So the Nexus 5, well, 6P is going to have a 5.7 Quad HD high resolution screen. I think that's a 1080p, or is it a No, I think that's 1440p display. So it's not 4K, but I think it'll do. It's better than 1080. So also it'll have a metal unibody, and it's gonna be slim. So it's gonna be a thin phone. I don't know how thin. I don't know if it's gonna be iPhone 6 thin or like a Samsung Note 5 or Note 4 thin, but it's gonna be thin. So you get a metal unibody, so this means no removable back, which also means no removable battery, and it might, I don't know yet, it might have expandable storage, but this isn't, I don't have it, so I wouldn't know. It's gonna ship with Android Marshmallow, so you get all the nice little Marshmallow features, like what is it, Now on Tap and Snooze, and I think you get a dark theme in the settings, I'm not sure. You'll also get the Snapdragon 810 2.1 processor. So this is the Snapdragon version that has no overheating issues. Now the OnePlus 2 had this version of the 810, but it still had overheating issues. But the problem is that you need an extra heat valve, like in the Sony Xperia Z5. They added an extra heat valve in the Z5 Premium or the Z5, which diminished the overheating problem. So Xperia fixed it, and everybody else that wants to use the 810 should add an extra heat valve instead of worrying about the 2.1. Also, the 6P will support a massive 3,450 milliamp battery, which is the biggest battery I've seen in any smartphone in a while. It's bigger than my Note 4's battery, which is a 3,200 or 3,100. I don't remember, but this should get you a lot of screen on time, which we really need. I'm glad that Nexus, or who made this one? Well, whoever made this Nexus, I'm glad that they're setting an example that if you have a bigger phone, the battery should be huge also. So, thank you for whoever made this Nexus 6P. I think it was Huawei, or was it LG? I'm not sure. But yeah, whoever made this one, good example. Anyways, it'll also have two front-facing speakers. There's not gonna be any home button and stuff like the Samsung devices. All those are on screen. So yeah, you get two dual front speakers, which might, I hope they support better sound than the Motorola devices, because that would be amazing. But yeah, two front-facing speakers, and you also get USB Type-C. I think the Nexus 6P is going to be the second phone to have USB Type-C. The OnePlus 2 was the first phone, so you get a USB Type-C, and also you get fast charging with the USB Type-C. So the Nexus 6P is the first device to have USB Type-C and fast charging. So yeah, this is going to be an amazing phone from what I've seen. Only if they waited a little bit to get the 820, that would be a little bit better. Or you never know, there could be another Nexus by then that's going to just kick this out of the water. So thanks for watching this video, and see you in the next one. Peace.